Today on Making It Home, I'm going to show you how to make a bowl on a CNC machine and put a logo in it that goes all the way through. To get the project started, I set up the X-Carve CNC machine and started carving the logo. I'm carving this logo in the regular orientation using a downcutting bit so the edges are nice and clean. The idea is when I get done, I'm going to take this, insert it in the bottom of the blank of wood in the pocket, and then it's going to be in the right orientation. I'm only cutting about halfway through this piece of wood. The plan is when I get done, I'll take this over to the bandsaw and I'll slice the logo off of the piece of wood. If you only have a couple pieces of wood you're going to be using for this, I would highly recommend running some test pieces on some scrap material. After carving the logo, I cut off the excess material and then headed over to the bandsaw to cut the logo loose. I set the thickness on the bandsaw fence to the depth of the CNC carve and then just pushed it through slowly. It's really critical that when you do this operation that you have a tall fence that will keep the piece perfectly vertical. If your fence isn't completely vertical, the problem you may have is that one side of your logo may be thicker than the other, and this could cause problems when you actually put it into the pocket on the back of the piece of wood. So now you can see the inlay sitting on top of the pocket that's been carved out, and it is very tight. My tolerances were a little too close, and so I had some issues getting this into the block of wood. It even got more difficult because as I added glue, I think the pieces started swelling up and the fit got even tighter. I got the logo started into the pocket with a rubber mallet, and then I actually had to use a piece of wood and really pound hard to get this thing to go into the pocket all the way. I was very concerned that I was going to break the logo. Next, I started carving a nearly identical logo in the bottom of another piece of wood, and this one I decided I was going to fill with epoxy. I decided to carve this one just a little bit deeper at a half inch deep so I could fill it with the epoxy. I added a strip of caulking around the pocket just in case I poured too much epoxy. I got a great tip from Wicked Makers on YouTube. Basically what you do is you take household craft beads or some kind of small granular material and you pour it into your logo cut out or your pocket in your piece of wood. And then when you pour that out and put it into a measuring device, you can basically see how much volume you'll need of epoxy to fill that up. It may look a little silly at first, but it works incredibly well. I barely had any excess epoxy. I used some black diamond pigment to really give the epoxy a black appearance, but it actually has some flecks in it so it sparkles a little bit in the sunlight. Make sure you mix this up to a really consistent layer. A little tip that I found was that you can actually put a popsicle stick into the chuck of a drill and use that to mix your cup of epoxy. Next, I poured the epoxy into the pocket on the bottom of the bowl. The epoxy I used is very thin and it takes a couple days to cure, so make sure you're pouring on a level surface. After the epoxy is completely set up, I put this back in the CNC machine and started leveling out the bottom of the bowl. I took very short passes and then sanded it at the end. Since I was making several versions of the bowl with the same logo, I decided to flatten the next piece out as well. This one had a padauk logo with cherry as the main piece of wood. Now the padauk was sitting a little high on the board, so this one took a little bit longer to flatten out than the epoxy because that was sitting flush with the surface of the wood. So after flattening, this is what the bowl looked like on the bottom. I took it down flat and then I actually sanded with 180 grit sandpaper. At this point, I was shocked at how tight the logo was in the base piece of wood, but if you remember right, this is the piece of wood I actually had to hammer the logo down into, so it was a very tight fit to begin with. The last piece to flatten was a piece of maple with a lacewood inlay. So here are the three different pieces ready to be carved. In the top left, we have black epoxy in a cherry base, and in the top right, we have padauk in a cherry base. The bottom piece is actually a little different. It's shorter, and it is a piece of lacewood and a piece of maple. There might be some people watching this who understand that the logo is in the wrong direction, and that's okay because this is actually the bottom that you're looking at. When I flip these over and carve the bowl or the tray section out, then they're going to be pointed in the right direction to the right. The first of these I cut was the lacewood in the maple base, and this one turned out really well. I thought I'd start with one that was a little thinner just in case I ran into issues. Next, I started carving on the padauk and the cherry, and this one worked out great, except I did not have my depth set to the right level. So when I got done, I actually had a little bit left to get down to the padauk. In order to fix this one, all I had to do was use my trim router with the same bowl router bit and go down just a little bit deeper to clear that out. I carved the epoxy bowl out last. This one I was really concerned about with the depth of the epoxy and how deep I would go with the bowl cutting bit. But it actually turned out exactly as I had planned, so sometimes over planning does help in the end. You'll notice that carving the epoxy does throw a lot of those little router bit shavings up all over the place, and they do have a static charge to them, so this can really turn into a mess. A little sanding in the bottom of the bowl took care of all the little edges from the router bit. Next, it was off to the bandsaw to cut the bowl loose from the blank of wood. I used a flush trim router bit to take care of the excess part that you see around the bottom edge. This is a lot faster than trying to carve all the way through that blank of wood on the CNC machine, and my router bit wasn't long enough. With the edges of the bowl all trimmed up, I took a 1/8 inch radius roundover bit and put a nice soft edge on the inside and outside of the bowl. I also used the same router bit to round over the bottom edge of the bowl just so it had a soft feel as well. With that bowl pretty much complete besides fine sanding, I went back to finish cleaning out the bottom of the bowl that had padauk and cherry. I used my router sled on this with a trim router and the same bowl bit and slowly worked down little by little to get to where I had carved off the entire surface of the padauk. This bit has a bearing around the top, so I actually used the inside top of the bowl to guide it around the edge. So with the bowl finally carved down to the proper depth to where the padauk was flush with the bottom of the cherry, then I started working on rounding over the edges on this one. I pretty much went through the same process with all three of these, but they all ended up slightly different. This saved a lot of time and setup since everything was the same size and needed the same bits. Next, it was time to see how these things looked with a good coat of finish on them. I used Odie's oil on these. It's a nice food safe product that brings out a really good look to the wood, and it also works well on the epoxy. Just take your time and wipe on the finish. You actually wipe this on and then give it 10 to 15 minutes and then wipe off the excess. I used a soft Scotch-Brite pad to work this into the wood fibers, and it worked really well. This is actually the first project that I used Odie's oil on, and I really, really like it. It goes on really easy, it smells good, it doesn't have horrible vapors to it, and it brings out the color of the wood really nice. I should also say that it is fantastic to be able to put on a coat of finish and not have to worry about it setting up before you're completed. man, I love the way that turned out. Next, we put the Odie's oil on the maple and lacewood tray. This really brought out the figure in the wood, as you can see as I tilt it left and right. Again, this stuff is really great to put on since you can take your time putting it on and then you have about 10 to 15 minutes before you wipe off the excess. And lastly, I put on the coat of finish on the padauk and cherry. This really brought out the color of the padauk. So here's a little comparison on all three bowls or trays now that they're all done and have finish on them. The black epoxy and cherry I think turned out really well. One of the nice things about this is the black epoxy, when it's sitting on a table, looks completely black, but when you hold it up, you can see some light through it. The padauk and cherry I think looks really great with the contrast between the two different types of wood. And as you can see, the logo is incredibly tight with the other piece of wood. The maple and lacewood tray I think looks really cool from a standpoint that the lacewood looks kind of like the texture of a football. And that Odie's oil really brought out the figure in the maple. I love the way it looks as you tilt it left and right, and you can kind of see the light change the figure in the wood. Thanks for watching today. I hope you enjoyed the video. This was a very challenging project and I really didn't know what to expect by doing the inlays and the epoxy pour, but next time I think it'll be a lot easier. Make sure you subscribe. I've got a bunch of woodworking, metalworking, and electronics videos coming out soon. And you can also go check out some of my older videos.